I really have no idea, but that would be kind of cool, wouldn't it be? Here she is now. It's All the Good Girls Go to Hell on the Shark. Hey, what's going on? It's Hobart. Welcome to another video. Welcome to my channel. This time I'm doing it from the front of the camera instead of being behind the camera. And the reason why I am doing a video is because I wanted to explain a little bit more the difference between a regular earbud and an IEM and why you should own a pair of IEMs and not own earbuds. So what are IEMs? IEMs are in-ear monitors. It's a fancy way of saying a speaker that goes inside of your ear. So where did they come from? Why do we have them? Well, one of the major reasons is because of musicians. If you've been to a concert, you know, in the last 20 years or so, you might have seen the real big triangle, they call them wedge speakers, that used to sit on stage in front of every artist. And that's because you can't hear yourself play when you're on stage. Now, I know all of you want to go backstage. Oh, I want to go backstage. I want to be on stage while the artist is playing. But take it from a guy who's been in radio for 20 years, it does not sound good when you're backstage. All the sound is meant to go forward out to the crowd. And so you can't hear yourself when you're playing your guitar or even when you're playing drums. So you had these big speakers on stage that would play what you're playing and what the rest of the band is playing to you so you could hear them. Well, technology came out and now you'll see the artist. They'll have the, have you ever seen the artist with the speaker in their ear that goes over the top of their ear and goes down their shirt? That's what they're doing. It's an in-ear monitor. And what that does is it allows them to hear themselves and the rest of the band without having to have a big speaker on stage anymore. So that's what an IEM is, mainly for musicians. But why can't the average Joe use them? I just want to hear good sound when I'm listening to it on my phone, or I'm listening to YouTube, or I'm listening to my iPhone. So why can't I own some IEMs? Well, you can, and it's actually very affordable. I myself have been in radio for 20 years, and I've had everything from, you know, the Sony Professionals and the Sony Studios and the Sennheisers, you name it, I've had it. But they were all over-the-ear headphones. They're good. But until I put these on, I had no idea what I was missing out on. So, what is the difference between an earbud and an IEM? Well, the regular earbud, like, you know, the Apple Pod or the AKG-tuned Samsung earbuds that you get with your Samsung Galaxy phone, or maybe you got a set of Skull Candy that you bought for $5 or $10, you know, at the store. Those are not tuned for good quality sound. They may be okay. I'm not saying the Apple Pods are bad. I'm just saying that they're not as good as you can get for a lot less money. Most of the regular earbuds are going to be one single speaker. It's not going to be a very good speaker. The speaker is going to have to do all of the work. It's going to have to do the bass work, the mids work, and the highs work, all with one speaker. So you're not going to really be getting the best sound that you could be getting out of your earbud. So you got one speaker in there. These right here have five speakers in each earbud. And I'll talk about that more in a second. Now, the IEMs, those are made for good quality sound. Now, they can be tuned for specific instruments. So if you're a drummer, you might want to hear, or a bass player, you might want to hear more highs so you can hear the rest of the band. If you're a guitar player or a singer, you may want to hear everybody equally. So there are IEMs that the professionals use that are tuned specifically for an instrument. And a lot of times those are going to be really expensive. Most of the artists today will have the IEM customized for their ear, and that involves going to an audiologist. They put a foam or a silicone in your ear and fill it up, and then they send that mold to the company, and they actually make the IEM specifically for your ears and your ears only. Hey, I would love to be able to afford that, but you're talking hundreds into thousands of dollars in order to get those. So how can I get an affordable pair of IEMs when you're telling me, Hobart, that they cost hundreds and hundreds of dollars? I'm just going to use my regular earbuds. Well, China got into the mix and started producing some really good high quality and really good sounding IEMs for a fraction of the price. So inside of an IEM, you can have three different options. You can have one or two dynamic drivers, which are the regular round speakers we all know and love that vibrate, create frequencies, and we hear them with our ears. You can get all balanced armature drivers, which I'll explain what those are in a second, or you can get a mixture of both in a hybrid. So what is a balanced armature driver? Well, balanced armature drivers are really small little speakers that were first introduced into hearing aids. They needed a really small speaker that could be put inside of an acrylic or a plastic mold and be shoved inside someone's ear so that they could hear better. Now, that, over time, with technology, evolved into, hey, what if we could put those into a headphone that an artist can wear on stage and still be able to have a small, compact package and get it into their ears? And so they started putting balanced armature drivers inside of headphones for the artists. And here we are today, where not only do you have balanced armature drivers and dynamic drivers, you got hybrids that have both of them in there. You have some that have one balanced armature driver and some that have five balanced armature drivers. So what is the difference? Well, the balanced armature driver, and I'm not trying to be crazy technical here, they are little speakers that are tuned to a specific frequency range. So we've all heard of bass, we've all heard of mids, we've all heard of highs. So in a regular earbud, you've got your one speaker trying to handle all of the work. While in the IEM, when you have either a dynamic and multiple balanced armature drivers or all balanced armature drivers, then you've got the load being shared between the different speakers or different drivers. And these, the KZ-ZS10 Pros, these have one dynamic driver. So that handles all of the bass frequencies, gives you real nice pump and bass. You feel the thump. The dynamic driver's really good at that. But it doesn't have to do any of the other work. It doesn't have to do the mids work. It doesn't have to do the highs work. So we can just do a really good job at giving me the bass. But this also has four balanced armature drivers. Two of them take care of the mid-range frequencies, and two of them take care of the high-end frequencies. So when you take all of that and you put that together inside of your ear, you get incredible high-quality hi-fi sound. And what I mean by that, if you're listening to maybe a song you've heard many a times before, I promise you, you're going to hear instruments, notes, noises, things that you've never heard when you have these in your ears, because your standard earbud may not have been tuned so that you can hear that frequency. So there may be a real high, bing, bong, bong, you know, something that you, what is that? You're going to recognize and notice things that you've never heard, because these are now able to handle a really low frequency up to a really high frequency, and everything in between you get to hear. While on just a regular earbud, it may be only tuned here, so anything below or anything higher, it leaves out and you don't get to hear it. So once you put these babies in, it's like you've opened up yourself to a whole new world of sound. And take it from a guy who's been in radio for 20 years, who's had lots of different headphones, who's heard music in the headphones, who's heard music in person, who's been on stage, who's talked to artists who have professional IEMs, and it's just the way that you need to go. That's just what I'm saying. It's my personal opinion, but take it from a guy who's very skeptical when it comes to new things and likes to do a lot of research before he makes the switch. I think I did probably 3 or 4 months of research. I watched numerous YouTube videos. I read tons of articles on just what an IEM was, how they work, why they're better, et cetera, and that's why I'm making this video, because I'm trying to save you months of research. And just believe me when I say, try a pair of IEMs, you won't regret it. So the price point is another thing that makes these things amazing. Now you can, the professionals, those custom molded ones I was talking about earlier, those can start in the few hundreds and get up into the thousands of dollars. If you can afford that, great. But not everybody can. But everybody does want to hear high quality audio. So what do you do? Well, the Chinese got into it and they came out with IEMs that are not only affordable, but sound great. Now, they don't use the balanced armature drivers like the, you know, high-end guys use, which are Knowles, K-N-O-W-L-E-S. Those are the real good balanced armature drivers. But we all know that China's great at copying things. So they've come out with their own balanced armature drivers, tuned to their own specific frequencies, and you're going to pay a fraction of the cost. These, the KZ-ZS10 Pros, which I do have a video review on if you want to watch and get a little bit more in depth on these. It's on my channel. These cost me $40. Now, like I said, I did a lot of research, and everybody was coming back to the KZ ZS10 Pro as being an amazing IEM that gives you everything you need. You got one dynamic driver, you got good bass, you got four balanced armature drivers, so you have really good mids and highs. They're extremely clear, they're extremely comfortable, and it only cost you $40. Tell me where you're going to get Apple Pods for $40 with four balanced armature drivers and one dynamic driver in there. Tell me where you're going to get, you know, some of these other high-end headphones that, you know, Beats headphones. $40. I bet you they sound better than the Beats headphones. I'm not knocking them. I'm just saying, why pay hundreds of dollars when you don't have to if you're only looking for sound? If you want to be cool and have the pod hanging out to your ear like is the style these days, fine, go ahead. But if you're looking for really good sound, IEMs are the way to go. So let me just kind of go over a little bit about the IEM. One, they're extremely comfortable, okay? You put these on, you shove them in your ear, they go over the back of your ear, okay? They don't fall out. You can shake your head, you can headbang, you can do whatever you want, and they don't come out of your ear. Plus, if you've ever pulled on your cord when they're in front of you, or they're not over your ear and they fall out, the good news is these go over your ear, so they're nice and supported. They don't fall out, they stay on. The other thing is these seal because they go in your ear. You see how long that is? That goes in my ear. It actually seals so no outside noise gets in. It's like the best noise canceling headphone you've ever had in your life. It's incredible. Now, I use the silicone tips when I'm at work because I need to put them in and take them out quickly for work. But when I'm listening personal music, I use the memory foam tips. And the reason that there's a difference is because the memory foams, you're supposed to squeeze a little bit and put them in your ear and hold them there while they expand and seal up your ear canal. And sometimes I just don't have the time for that. So I use the silicone ones at work, but there are also memory foam ear, for the IEMs, memory foam ear tips that you can put in, and they seal the outside out. And when I say seal the outside up, what I mean is you can turn your music on and you can sing as loud as you want and you cannot even hear yourself sing. That's how noise canceling and how in your ear the IEMs are. So you got a better price, $40 compared to pods. What are those? $150, $200. And they do not have the sound that these do by any means whatsoever. They're cool, but if you're looking for good sound, this is the way to go. And when it comes to the ease of use, these are absolutely easy to use. You can wear them down your shirt like I do. You can wear them in front if you want to, but they still go over your ear and they don't fall out. They do come with a regular 3.5 millimeter plug-in. So you can plug it into your cell phone if you still have a port. You can still plug it into your cell phone. And if you want, you can buy the Bluetooth attachment that allows you to go completely wireless and Bluetooth. But the good news is you can plug those in because these unplug. So if you go, well, Hobart, I don't have a jack in my phone anymore. Sorry, I can't use those. Yes, you can. Because you can actually detach those, attach the Bluetooth cord, and now you've got Bluetooth IEMs. You're not sacrificing the sound, and you're still getting the portability and the ease of use, especially if you don't have a headphone jack anymore on your phone. You can still get good quality sound. So these are what they look like. As you can see, they're molded, so they fit in your ear. And as you can see, when I put it in there, it stays. It looks good. Nice profile. You're out running, very aerodynamic, but they stay. Look, even without a cord on them, they don't fall out. Now, I was talking about the dynamic driver, which is the round speaker that we're all used to, and that is it right there. You can see the round disc. Hopefully it's focusing. I can't see. That is your dynamic driver. Okay, so there's one of those, and then there are four balanced armature drivers, and you can see them right here in the corner. If you look in the corner, you see those silver rectangles. There's two of them right there. That is how small a balanced armature driver is, hence why they started in hearing aids, because they needed to be really small. And they're able to fit inside of a package that can go in your ear. So that is what an IEM looks like. I'll take the ear tip off so you can kind of see that as well. They have a little grate here so you don't get earwax and dirt and stuff in there. And then there's your connection. If your cord goes bad, you can buy another cord for $10 and you don't have to buy new headphones. One of the bad things about earbuds is, at least wired ones, I know we're in the Bluetooth wireless age now, but the wired earbuds, if the cord goes bad, you gotta go get new headphones, which means you're throwing away good headphones. These detach, so you just get a new cord. If you wanna change the cord, upgrade the cord, it's easy to do. So that's what a balanced armature driver looks like right there at the end. That is what a dynamic driver looks like right there. All together, I've got 5 speakers in this ear, I've got 5 speakers in this ear, and I have incredible sound. So hopefully I taught you a little bit more about why you should own a set of IEMs and why they're way different than just a regular pair of headphones. Hopefully also you'll understand that there's no reason to spend $100, $150, $200 on a set of headphones that don't sound anywhere near as good as these do. I bought these on Amazon for $40. And there's a lot of other ones out there that are less than these, and there's others that are more than these. Until you step up into the professionals and the custom molded IEMs, there's no reason you need to spend over $100 on a good set of earphones. So I highly suggest the KZ-ZS10 Pros, not because anybody paid me to do it, because I absolutely love these things. I use them for work all the time. I use them for personal time. And overall, they just have the best soundstage, general soundstage for the average listener. I don't need tons of bass. I don't want all treble. I want it to be overall sounding good, and that's what these are right here, the KZ-ZS10 Pros. Like I said, there is a video on my channel. If you want to go and watch the in-depth review of the KZ-ZS10 Pro, I kind of touch a little bit on what I am here in the video about what the differences are, but I wanted to go a lot more in-depth on why you should own a pair, what the differences in the technology is, what the differences in the price are, and there's absolutely no reason for you to be spending over $100 on a pair of headphones. And now that you know what an IEM is, how comfortable they are, how durable they are, how good they sound, there should be no reason why you shouldn't be tossing those pods or those AKG Samsungs in the trash and going online and finding yourself a set of IEMs, okay? Appreciate you watching my video. I appreciate you tuning into my channel. If you like what I do here, please click the subscribe button. It helps my channel more than you know. And of course, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down in the comment sections. I would be happy to answer them for you. And I'll also put a link down there as well to these IEMs and maybe to a couple different websites so that if you're new to this, I can kind of point you in the right direction of where you should start. And then you can make your own decision from there, okay? Well, again, thank you so much. Happy New Year to everybody. My name is Hobart. Have yourself a great rest of your day. See ya.